I was walking through town. It was probably the slowest I've ever walked in my life. As the sun started to set on the city, I kept having trouble walking forward. But I couldn't stop. I realized that I wasn't supposed to be here. So I forced myself to keep going. For some reason, once I got away from Miyashiro, my headache stopped. It was as if his very existence was the cause of it.
Ah, so ka. Kyote.
I looked at all the happy girls and remembered. February 14th. Valentine's Day. The day when girls told boys they liked them.
私、あんたみたいなやつ、大嫌い。
I hadn't really been thinking about it when I said it. It wasn't often that you told someone to their face that you didn't like them. You only realize what you really wanted to say after you said goodbye. Was it a line from a movie? Who did I consider it with? I laughed, even though I thought it was stupid. I was happy now. I bet the old me was a nasty girl who hadn't been happy at all. But now, I had forgotten all about it. I had forgotten all about it. And I could be happy. That's right. I was happy now. That was why I had to laugh.
ねえ、セリカ、あなたはどこへ行く気なの？
I asked myself, but I didn't answer. I just kept walking. I was walking in a crowd full of people. As I walked, I still began to figure out how much of the world was real.All the nightmarish things that had happened. All these people were walking without knowing anything about them. Which world was real? It had to be this one. The big TVs were playing wonderful music. And there was a delicious smell coming from the crab stand.This was the right world. The fun world. It had to be this world. But I knew that this was a lie. But I pretended I didn't. And I kept smiling and walking. I was a liar.Someone who was honest with themselves, like maybe a child or something, might have gone back to a basement. Because this town, this place, it should be so much fun. But it felt so awful. I couldn't find the place where I belonged. But I couldn't go back to the basement.I wasn't a kid anymore. Not anymore. I was a lying grown up. Suddenly, a scene from the nightmare came back. fragments of memories I'd seen there. We were scattered about like the pieces of a puzzle. And they were eating away at me. And beyond them, I remembered a tiny little feeling.
これ、どうにかしてよ。ねえ。
There was probably no way to get it back. I'd realized that no matter who I asked, it was the one thing they would never tell me. The memories and feelings kept spinning around inside me. I wanted to go back there, but I couldn't. I got walking with nowhere to go. And eventually, I found myself in front of a building near the station. Is this the Ikario? It has been 30 minutes since the sunset.
Nandokke? Ikario?
I looked up at the tall building. I couldn't tell how many floors it was. I couldn't remember ever coming here. But my body went inside without hesitation. I stepped out of the elevator and saw a pretty theater. I could see a poster for a musical on the wall. There was a picture on it that I'd seen somewhere before. Soiree was just about to start. Dieter Linko did her first own performance held in the evening. A daytime performance is a matinee. I stood in line to buy a ticket. Luckily, there was a seat open near the front of the house. I bought my ticket and buried myself in the waves of people going into the theater.
ここ、確か。
What? Something was strange. I thought I'd never been here before, but it was familiar. I had come here before. I walked up the stairs through the crowd and opened the door to the theater. And this was the final confrontation between Takeru and Sarika. And when I stepped inside, I heard a sound like something bursting within me. Something snapped within my head. I walked towards my seat. I slowly weaved my way to the other audience members, going down the steps of the corridor. The curtain was lowered and lit. There was a projection with the name of the musical and an illustration on it. But what I was seeing was an empty theater, an empty stage, lit up by bright lights. I sat in my seat, and after a while the buzzer rang, and the curtain came up. The orchestra made a low sound that echoed in the pit of my stomach, and the cast came up on stage. But my mind was still seeing the same thing. I was still looking at the empty stage.
ここで、私は…
On stage, the actors started to pantomime rowing about. They were creating a delusional world on the stage, filled with things that didn't exist. But I was seeing a different world, It was the world I'd lived in before. The musical kept going. But the empty stage that only I saw didn't change. My memories ached. My feelings threatened to overflow. I'd done something here with someone. The sadness from when I talked with them was filling my heart. The pain in my throat when I screamed at them was coming back at me. It hurt to breathe. I was gasping like I was underwater. The actors sang, their voices riding on the powerful music. It was a song the heroes sang to inspire themselves and the people before they went off to fight the revolution. The people of this fictional world all lined up and yelled. "Come along and join us," they sang. And then it happened. I saw someone on the empty stage. They were holding something up high in their hands. I could see that it was a sword, gleaming with a little shine. It was a tool for battle.
それが僕があいつにできる唯一の償いだから。僕たちは一緒にいたら何も変わることができない。離れたからこそ僕もあいつももう間違えない。男が好きな子にすがりついて生きてくなんてできるわけないだろ。
あれ
I just look at this. I was crying. It was the same tears I felt on my cheek when I woke up this morning. I quickly wiped them away with the back of my hand. I need to blow my nose. That build-up was so powerful. But they didn't stop. I can't wipe them away. And they didn't stop coming. That's no good. They wouldn't stop. I couldn't stop them. I buried my face in my hands. That's what I did just now. But my microphone is noise gated, so I'm not sure if the microphone picked it up. Oh, this is powerful.
したことに悔いはない。満足してるんだ。
このクズ。続き、ずっと隣にいたって誰？
I love how in this moment all the puzzle pieces Erica had are just coming together.
親友だよ。
親友なんていたんだね。あんなひどい殺人を犯すようなあんたにも。あんたの親友って同じように症候群者だったの？今何をしてるの？
いや、普通の人だった。もう亡くなったよ。彼女はこの世界のどこにもいない。
The play ended and the audience gave a standing ovation. The actor stood on the stage and bowed. Away my tears. I sat there for a long time unable to get up. No one else could see the blurry world I saw. I looked up to stop the tears from falling down. And the lights on the stage shone down on me like a spotlight. I just have no words. That was amazing. I'm really struggling not to break down again. But those lyrics, that ending song, that was really, really good. And I'm so glad that we have some kind of epilogue. I just don't want this game to end, honestly. It's just... It's just I can't handle goodbyes very well, and I'm just not ready to say goodbye to this game. October 2016, 8 months later.
次の検査は来週の同じ時間になりますので、お大事に。
はい、ありがとうございました。
She bowed to the nurse. Oh, she's come to know quite well. My name is Sandri. The girl who was once Crucinando checked the time. It was almost noon. The exams were getting shorter and shorter. They hadn't even given her any drugs today. But that probably meant she was getting better.
Nesan!
Yamato Yuki, whose exam had evidently been as short as hers, came down from the psych ward on the fifth floor. When she saw Zenri, she ran over.
ねえさんも今日は終わり？
こら、病院内は走らない。
はい、ごめんなさい。
Sunri felt herself smile as she watched her little sister walk fast, but not run, toward the front desk. Her little sister had struggled with her physical therapy, but now she could walk and run like a normal girl. She wanted to be a nurse, just like Sunri. It would be the perfect job for her.
じゃあ行こっか。思ったより早かったから、みんなをランチに誘ってみる？来てくれると思うわ。
うん。
Yuki suddenly seemed to remember something and stopped.
忘れ物？
うん、その…
Yuki was choosing her words carefully as she looked at the elevator that had just come down.
いいの、姉さん。
Yuki put her hand on the little sister's head.
ちゃんと挨拶は済ませたでしょ？それでもう十分。それに、最近は警備が厳重で 誰も近寄れないわ。
でも、
だからいいのよ、ウキ。そうしちゃダメなんだから。ね。
I don't just nodded a second later. I suddenly smiled.
Take care, お疲れ様です。
I'm so glad to see Senri and Arimura and everyone again.
お疲れ様です。
When she contacted them over the phone, she found that Arimura Inai and Kasuki Hana had both been waiting for her call all morning. I'm sorry, it's just... my nose is stuffy. So I probably sound a bit off. I met in front of the GBS station and started walking. It had been a long time since the four of them had gone through the city together like this. They saw each other often at the hospital, but their exams and physical therapy were all at different times, which made it hard to schedule anything. But today, it was a special day. Even if they didn't say anything, they all knew they were going to meet.
今日、ユウは？
ユウとなら、学校のお友達と図書館へ行ったわ。
うわ、せっかくの休みに図書館とか。末恐ろしいなあ、おい。
ユウは将来、弁護士になるって張り切ってるから。
おへえ、弁護士？子供の夢にしちゃ、ずいぶん。
Oh, so that's it, Inai almost said, but she stopped herself. Both Hana and Inai immediately understood the meaning of Tachibana Yuto's childlike dream, as well as the fact that it might even come true. And Yuto knew what day it was too.That had to have been why he went to the library with his friends, just like the four of them had gathered together. An indescribable sadness was threatening to build up between them. It was Arimura's loud voice that broke the silence.
Minano-shu, のんびりしてるとどの店も満席になっちまいますぜ。
そうね、どこで食べる？
超お腹空いてるので、いつものカフェでいいと思います。どう？みんな。
うん、それでいい。私もそこで。
うん、じゃあそうしましょうか。
はーい、ではお姉さんについてきてください。
Inai raised one hand up like a tour guide and met the other around Hana's. The two of them had been hanging out together a lot recently. Then she plunged into the crowd. There were no Kale Shell Syndrome patients to be seen. Eight months ago, over 80% of the Kale Shell Syndrome patientsAnd Shibuya all fell unconscious at once. They were all quickly split up and taken to nearby hospitals. The hospitals were overflowing with patients. It's almost like the earthquake 6 years ago. No, 7 years now. Even those patients who had escaped the initial wave quickly fell unconscious as well, and were also taken to hospitals. Fortunately, no one was seriously injured.Several people were injured when they'd fallen, but none of them badly. And several days later, the patients began to wake up. Almost all of them in a state of extreme panic. They couldn't believe their real forms. Sanri, Hinai, and the others woke up at the same time and were terribly confused. But they didn't panic like the others. They quickly realized that he was involved and that he had done this for everyone's sake. And so, all the patients returned to a normal but harsh reality.
Minamisawa-senpai, let's go away from the line. I'll leave it. Oh, yes.
Sorry.
Sanri realized that she'd stopped walking as she reflected on the past. She ran to catch up with the others. What had happened when she was asleep? Right after she'd woken up, Taku had told her himself. Konosato and Shinjo had let her meet him in a special hospital room. He also told her about Serika's true nature and the truth behind the return of the new generation madness. Wakui, the committee, and Kyoshiel syndrome too. He told her about everything. And lastly, he told her the truth about Sakuma, the father she had believed in. I would argue that that would have been the biggest shock. And it was something that she, Minamisawa Sanri, or Kurusu no Nao, depending, had to tell him to. And that she didn't look like Kurusu no Nao anymore. There was no way she could keep up the lie. Oh, of course. This route, they never had that conversation. So now, basically, her hand was forced. Oh, that must have been incredibly difficult. She had trouble with working up the courage. I can't read anymore. Before she went into the decorator's room, she'd hesitated so many times and almost thought about not meeting him at all, but it was the other girls from her room that had scolded her and urged her on. She'd been the last one to wake up because of the wound in the chest. And by the time she did, Uki, Hina, and Hana had already seen the real her, and if a friend had forgiven her without saying a word. But when she'd hesitated about meeting Takeru, they had gotten really mad. "Can't you trust him?" they asked. "Is he the kind of guy who wouldn't forgive you?" And that was enough for her to decide. After she told him everything, Taku had laughed gently.
Baka da na. Motto hayaku hanashite kureleba yokatta no ni.
Every time she remembered his voice then, she felt like she would cry. And he gave up her old name and body and went back to being herself. She'd been forced into 6 months of physical therapy, not just because of the syndrome, but a stab wound as well. But at last, she was capable of going outside on her own. She had gone back to Heikyo Academy, which was now just a normal private school, and started living the life of a normal student, along with the others.
Ano?
Oh, gomenasai. Nani?
Kensa. どうでしたか?
いつも通りね。でももう薬も処方されてないし、そろそろ治療もおしまいかしら。カズキの方は？
うん、私もそうかも。
カズキ looks up at the sky as she spoke. He's been lying to everyone too, and just like Senri, she's been reluctant to admit it. And Tenai has scolded her too, when she opened up to Takeru about her lie. He forgave her like nothing was wrong at all. Even after losing her power, Hana still didn't talk a lot, but she was trying her best. It was her promise to Takeru, she thought.
その声、みんなにもっと聞かせてあげるといいよ。友達も増えるんじゃないかな。
Shibuya was filled with people, enjoying the day off, and Sanri and the others were living the same lives as everyone else. Except for one person, the boy who had been at their center. He had only brought it up during a small silence after they had eaten lunch at the usual cafe. At first, no one wanted to discuss it, but about the same time Sanri had gotten tired of watching the ice melt in her iced tea, Tenai opened her mouth to speak.
あの、見ましたか?
She pointed to the phone in her hand. It was displaying a gossip site. The article was about Takeru. It said that Miyashiro Takeru, the boy responsible for the serial killing in Shibuya, had been kept at Tokyo General Hospital doing the research on Girl Child Syndrome. And now that the research was mostly finished, he was finally being sent to a detention house for the real interrogations to begin. Even if he was a minor, in light of the effect the scribes had on society, the article said, there was no chance he would ever be getting out. It said all that in sensational and exaggerated tones.
こういうのどこで調べるのかしらね、マスコミって。
Most of what the article had said was right, and Shinji told them that the day Takeru would be transferred was today. Are we going to break him out?I wish that was possible, but I guess not. They were able to say goodbye a while before. Shinji had set it up. The last time they'd met, Taku had asked them for a favor. It involved Onu and Serika. Stay away from her.Unless he comes to you. If she does come to you, forgive her and treat her like a normal friend. And never tell her about me or her past. He had insisted on these three things until the very end.There will be a time where Serika remembers. Serika hadn't come to them at all. Kunisata told them that she lived in Yokohama and was attending Heikyo from there, but they hadn't heard anything else.
今、何してるのかな?
何してるのかしらね?
さあ。
No, not sure if Ugi's question was about Takeru or Sarika, or maybe both of them.
そろそろ行きましょうか。
I mean, it's kind of poetic in the sense that Takeru used Sarika as a means to deal with his problems, but now instead of using another person, I mean, he created Sarika for this purpose. Instead of using another person for that, he's actually taking responsibility for the first time. But I just feel so bad for Sarika. When she stood up to go, Sanri realized something. Oh, that's right. Maybe just asking about us. What are we doing right now? Takeru had a spot in the cafe, where he always sat. Sanri found herself looking at it, and almost cried again. The four of them left the cafe and slowly headed for the station. They planned to split up and go home from there. None of them were looking at their phones, but their heads were all bent lower than normal. But no one noticed. Just before the light turned green, Sanri realized that they were completely buried in the people surrounding them. The mouth opened on its own.
映画でも見ていきましょうか。
え？ The other three looked up in surprise. Their mouths fell in shock. They seem to have been caught completely off guard.
このまま帰ってもまだ早いし。
You're right. The sun hadn't even begun to set. And then suddenly started to tear at her hair.
ダメだ。今日はこんな空気にならないようにしようと思ってきたのに。
Her twin tails spun angrily.
そんなこと考えてたんだ。
そうじゃなきゃ、彼氏でもないあんたと手つないだりとかしないって。
最近よくつないでくるくせに。
知らん、誰だそれは。
はい、シェペス。
はいはい、じゃあ付き合ってくれるのね、映画。
バチコイ。
みんな、クラッターハンスゲッター。And then spread her arms as if to give Sanri a hug.
Uki は？この後予定ないでしょ？
でも。
Uki made the same face she made at the hospital. Let's go back to the hospital after all, she seemed to say.It's almost time, isn't it? Sanri knew Uki was worried about her. And that's when she smiled back, silently.
ありがとう。でも、行くならやっぱり映画にしましょう。ね。
Because if she did meet Takeru, she would grab onto him and break down in tears.She didn't think she had it in her to control herself. And she didn't want to let her little brother see her like that. She was never going to let him worry about her again. So...
できれば楽しい映画がいいな。タクルに手紙を書きたいの。みんなで楽しい映画を見たわよって。
あ、私も書く。お手紙毎日書く。
毎日？これは負けていられないわね。
おお、ブラコン姉妹ですな。
And I tried to tease them, but they both looked back at her and spoke in unison, Sanrin mischievously and Uki extremely seriously.
いけない？自慢の弟なの。
自慢の兄です。
おう。
Nice staggered back in exhilarated astonishment. Sanrin gave her a pat to move her along.
ほら、早く。置いていくわよ。
Sanrin went to the front and started to walk. Unlike a moment ago, she was standing tall, ready to face whatever fate.Had in store for her. Yuki went after her, her footsteps steady and firm as well. The remaining two looked at each other for a moment, and then they started to laugh and ran to catch up to the sisters.
Ah, 待ってくださいよ、先輩、ウキ。
映画ならおすすめのあるんですけど。
花のおすすめはいつもバカ映画すぎて話になんない。
That's strange. There was supposed to be data in here.
おい、勝手に触るなと何度も言ってるだろう。
The door opened, and an angry Kunosato came inside.
すいません。
あいつらの結果なら、いつも通りクリーンだ。今のところ、再発の恐れはない。
I gave a small sigh of relief when I heard that. Good. The treatment seemed to be working well.
それで、いつまでのの、千里たちの検査って続くんですか？
お前、これから連れて行かれるときに、人の心配なんて。まあいい。そういうやつだったな、お前は。今、あいつらに行っているのは、染色体に異常が見られないかどうかの検査だけだ。まあ、健康診断みたいなものだが、少なくとも老化の原因が完全に突き止められるまでは検査は続ける。今は週に1回だが、検査回数は徐々に減らしていく予定だ。
いつ頃から減らしていけるんです？
I don't know, Kunosato said. From the way she was talking, she wasn't lying. She really didn't know. My role in researching and curing Chaos Child Syndrome had mostly come to an end after I created the image. All that was left was for Kunosato and the regular scientists to help her to figure out the scientific cause.But they seem to be having a hard time figuring out what caused the artificial aging process. As for what they knew now, There are structures called telomeres at the end of a chromosome, which are related to the aging process in some way. A repeated set of base pairs at the ends of a chromosome, since it has been confirmed that they get shorter with each cell division, and telomere shortening has been seen in patients suffering from accelerated aging disorders. It is believed that they are deeply connected with cellular aging, and thus with the aging of the entire body. There are signs that Kiel-Schell syndrome patients are artificially creating them inside their bodies. The false telomeres, shortened at a greatly accelerated rate, that drastically restricted the number of times a cell could divide. The hypothesis was that the brain recognized these artificial telomeres as real and initiated the aging process. But much of that was still in the realm of hypothesis, and Kunisato herself didn't seem satisfied with the explanation at all. But whatever the underlying principle was, when I asked her what had happened, she shrugged and said this.
精神や肉体がこう勘違いしているせいじゃないか。妄想の世界で生きるということは新しい自分に生まれ変わることだとな。
そうか。精神的な勘違いだけじゃなく、肉体的にも勘違いをしたんだ。
The phenomenon that these mistakes or errors would occur along the chromosome have been known in the medical world for a long time. That's right. It was the same mechanism as cancer. In other words, former Kiel-Schell syndrome patients are at a high risk of developing that disease. Sandri and the others would probably keep getting exams to look for those errors in their cells, all without knowing why. And according to Kunisato, she had no idea when those exams might end. They might go on forever.
実はお前に関して興味深いことがあるんだが。
ん？サト stared at me as if trying to peer into the bottom of my heart.
これから先、かなり長い間、お前はインターネットにアクセスできなくなる。生まれて初めてのことじゃないか。
Yeah, come to think of it, she was right. The internet already existed when I was born. And by the time I hit puberty, it was everywhere.
情報強者を自認していたお前が、その最大の手段を失い、情報の規制を受ける。場合によっては、情報から遮断されるかもしれない。そういう生活が当然となったとき、お前の思考回路は、それまでとどう変化するんだろうな。
A while ago, I might have panicked just thinking about it, but strangely, I didn't feel like it now.
激しい情報の波にさらされていたお前と、波の全くない、静かな海に漂うお前。精神的にどう変化するか、楽しみだよ。
前に約束しましたから、実験台にしていいですよ。
ああ。そうだったな。
伊藤のやつは症候群だけでなく、脳の方も随分回復してきたそうですね。助かりました。
助かったのは医学的な面だ。法的なことは知らんぞ。
Ginger told me that Ido would be prosecuted, but in the end, he'd probably be given treatment at a medical facility for minors.I didn't know how long it would take, but I was relieved to know that he would eventually go free. Remembering Yui made my heart ache, but it wasn't his fault.
Kunosato-san, what are you going to do from here?
I remembered something I wanted to ask before I left this place. Zato's eyebrows rose in surprise.
委員会への復讐を続けるつもりですか？
当然だ。枠井が言った通り、私は踊り続けるさ。
And then I saw a little smile form around her mouth.
そうか。なるほど。もしかしたらお前とは長い付き合いになるかもしれんな。ワクイはお前のことを観測し続ける。そう言ったんだろ。
ええ。
この先お前が自分に降りかかってくる状況に絶望し、あるいは恐怖し、再びギガロマニアックスとしての力を取り返してしまうか否か、それが奴とのゲームというわけだ。
ええ。
だったらお前は生かされ続ける。私もお前の観測を続けよう。奴の尻尾をつかむためにな。
いいか。
There was a knock at the door, and heard the voice I knew well. Shinjo came in with a serious look on his face. He was looking at me, seemingly uncertain as to what to say. I waited, motionless, until finally he sighed. Shinjo said the words.
時間だ。
はい。
I slowly stood up from the chair.Shinjo knew the truth, but still accepted my decision. I could do nothing but be grateful for that. I knew how hard that had to be for a detective.
今までありがとうございました。苦労かけました。
I bowed deeply.
いや、君に比べたらどうということはないさ。
He put his hand on my shoulder. It was big and strong. If I had an older brother, would he have been like this?
俺の方こそ、ありがとう。
There was another detective on the other side of the door, ready to take me to the transport. The rest of the world still didn't really know what I looked like after I had recovered from Kelsdale syndrome. It was Shinjo who had convinced the others that I was an outlast. If they didn't put the handcuffs on me and try to hide my face, thanks to that, I would be able to walk outside as a normal high school kid one last time.I bowed one last time to Shinjo, and then turned to Kunisato.
みんなのことよろしく頼みます。
ああ、またな。
Kunisato nodded weakly, and then nodded back. And then I headed for the exit.
ああ、Miyashiro.
I stopped and turned around.
危うく聞き忘れるところだった。取り立てて重要なことではないんだが。彼女の名前と年齢だ。なぜ彼女は尾上セリカだったんだ。年齢に意味はあったのか。
It was actually something I've been thinking about for a long time after we were first apart.Actually, never thought about it. Why that name specifically? If I think about it, weirdly enough, her name sounds similar to Takumi's. What was her name again? Seira, I think. You know, the one.In Takumi's delusions from that fictional anime. Also pink hair, family name. It was the very first step of a very big mistake. When I finally found the answer, I burst out laughing.
名前は僕の両親の名前をローマ字書きしたアナグラムでした。
Oh, that's actually really nice. Miyashiro Sanrio, Miyashiro Eriko.
本当の親に求めるようなことを僕は彼女に求めていたんでしょうね。だからそんな名前にしたんだと思います。
That's really really clever. I really like that reasoning.
でも親の役割を彼女に求めたのなら、年上に設定するはずだろ。
そんな風に親を求めている自分を認めたくなかったんです。だから彼女は年上ではいけなかった。僕が守るべき年下の女の子でなければいけなかった。子供ながらにつまらないプライドですね。今考えると本当に愚かでした。
そうか。
If I wasn't mistaken, I got a glimpse of gentleness in her expression.
でも、お前はちゃんと彼女を守った。今はもう、愚かじゃないさ。
I mean, that's everything that he's doing now. He's taking the fall. Just for the sole reason that Serica can live. I smiled back at her and turned away. I made my stride a little longer than usual. My resolve wouldn't waver. And then I stepped out the door. It's been forever since I've been outside, and the weather was beautiful. I do wonder though, Serica seemed to start remembering. I was so used to the darkness, that the strong sunlight stung my eyes. The wind was a little cold, but it felt good. It felt by, as if purifying my whole body. I was surprised not seeing any reporters or gawkers, but I learned later that Kay, aka Kunisato, had given the media and internet false information. I walked for a while, until I saw a black car stopped on the side of the road. It was probably the transport car. I felt a sense of déjà vu, and stopped to look around, and then I remembered.
そうか。
This was the corner Tokyo General Hospital. 6 years ago, during the earthquake, it had been an evacuation shelter. The detective saw that I stopped and asked me what was wrong. But there were too many feelings inside me to explain. That's right. This is where I created her. I stood there in silent shock. Nearby, really? Nearby, in the bright sunlight, just a few seconds away, if I were to run. She was standing there. The girl I thought for sure I would never meet again. looking at me. As if uncertain whether to smile, cry, or get mad. There's a girl next to her that I didn't know. About the same age. Why?
Nande?
I couldn't look away. I couldn't move. They're so close. But we were staring at each other across the distance. That could never be cross. The detective told me to start walking. I couldn't answer. I realized that my fists were clenched.
Serika?
Nani?
I had a pretty voice. The soft wind seemed to be carrying it to me.
どうしたの、いきなり。誰、あれ、知ってる人？
I didn't know what feelings were being exchanged between us, but I could see tears forming in her eyes.
うん、知らない人。
And the tears fell without a sound. She was smiling.The girl next to her must have been her best friend. She wiped away her tears and smiled, so that her friend wouldn't see them. And then, she turned around and walked away from me.Started to move again, and a smile formed on my face as well.
うん。僕も君なんて知らない。
The sun stung my eyes. I looked up at the sky, so that the sudden tears wouldn't fall on the ground. Cried tears of joy. That's what I believed. And that's what I had to believe. Everything. Everything was for the best.
すいません、行きましょう。
I said to the detective. Then I started to walk. I didn't look at her as she got further away.We would never see each other again. And the path we walked would never cross. was how we would live our lives together. The game. I'm just sitting here trying to collect myself. I cried 2 times. Then, when the epilogue began, my throat started to hurt just because of my crying, and I tried to hold it in, but at the end I just couldn't. This is such a good bittersweet ending, and I said before that I expected a bittersweet end. Since this is Gale's child, and like Gale said before it, it doesn't do happy endings. I'm extremely impressed by how good this game was. I'm so sad it's over. Let me go back to the main menu to see if it's changed. Yeah, the sky is blue now. I think the menu music is also different. I just don't know what to say at this moment. It was so good, the whole game was so good. All the character routes brought something to the table, you know? And it's just, I'm sad it's over. I think this is as good as Steins Gate, in my opinion, in my experience. There are a few things that I think Gale's Head did better. One of the bigger things was the delusions that Gale's Head were a little more visceral. especially the bad ones. And the fact that in my Chaos Head playthrough, I actually missed a lot of illusion triggers the first time because I didn't know what was happening. So I couldn't really tell what things were real and what things were delusions, but in this game I really love the characters. I just need to let this all sink in, but I mean, comparing this to Steins Gate, in my opinion, Steins Gate had an extremely good, extremely strong main story, which I think Chaos Child's story is maybe as good, but maybe Steins Gate, because of its ending, maybe a little better, just main part, but where I think that Chaos Child is a lot better than Steins Gate is the fact that in Steins Gate some of the character routes are just, although enjoyable, they were kind of filler-ish. Yeah, I really don't know what to say now. You know, at the end they almost played it like this. I mean, I guess the committee is the one big bad that connects all these games together, which is why Bakui is still at large. Since the main antagonist in this game basically was Sakuma, since he was collecting the experiments. As for final confrontations between Chaos Child and Chaos Head, I think Takumi's confrontation with Norose was a bit better. I don't know, I'm rambling at this point, but I'm glad that things were so different, and that's where I have to commend Chaos Child on being an excellent sequel, because the things with sequels were never something, a part of media, a story is popular and won't capitalize on it. Not saying that it was the case here, but normally when they make sequels, they would take elements for the first one and replicate them. But I love, in this case, how they expanded on the world and basically showed us one side of the ramifications of the events of Chaos Head and the other side, how it affected people. And also, this whole Chaos Child Syndrome thing. I really, really liked it, and I think I'll just stop rambling now because I don't really make a lot of sense. But yeah, Chaos Child is amazing, and like I said, I'm sad it's over. I really am. I'm just at this point where I had so much fun, I just want more of it. And especially at the end, they did leave room for a sequel, so maybe someday with new characters. Because obviously, Gigalomaniacs are still a thing. I really need to let this sink in. I do have an old Discord server where we have discussion channels for each series that I'm doing. So I'm going to discuss this game at length there. If you're interested, you can join. The link is in the description. And I will be starting as the music again. I will start a new series, obviously, and the series that will replace Guest Child will be Steins Gate Linear Bounded Phenogram. So that one will start Monday, and because that game is a bit of a shorter game compared to the original Steins Gate and Guest Child, I will be changing my upload schedule, but I'll make a separate video on that. So, as always, I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. And until next time,